from the clients eventually that we serve who are having to make hard choices about what they're doing with their hard-earned dollars. They're having to decide whether they're going to pay the rent, whether they're going to pay that heating bill, whether they're going to pay the lighting bill, or whether they're going to buy food. And of course, when we're making those hard kind of decisions, the food is often the component that gets left behind.
Sir Isaac Newton wrote the first comprehensive and accurate theory of gravity. His inspiration was an apple, but he was kind of special. For most people, an apple provides a very different kind of inspiration. In the modern world, an apple is grown, taken to market, and sold to someone who eats it. But how does even a simple apple make it to people who are too poor to buy it, but still need to eat? In the wealthiest nation on earth, tens of millions of people, over a third of them children, go to bed hungry every night. While the problem is certainly prevalent in rural communities, it's equally difficult to fight in urban areas like Chicago, where vast populations and high concentrations of poor make the distribution of sufficient food very difficult. In 1978, a group of volunteers formed a food bank to fight the problem. In 1981, Illinois legislators passed Good Samaritan laws to protect food donors from legal liabilities, and that food bank, the Greater Chicago Food Depository, responded with explosive growth in distribution. Today, the Food Depository distributes more than 40 million pounds of food annually through 600 qualified, nonprofit member agencies, such as soup kitchens, food pantries, and shelters. Their distribution chain includes grocers, institutional kitchens, warehouses, and independent volunteer and charitable agencies. It can be as elaborate as contracts with original food manufacturers or as simple as the agency mart, where agencies can obtain staple items on the spur of the moment, just as if they were shopping in a grocery store.
The Food Depository is a food bank. It's Chicago's food bank. It's one of the largest in the United States and one of the most sophisticated.
Okay, let's say our humble apple was picked, purchased, and sent to a kitchen there to be baked into a pie. Now, let's say that the kitchen happened to be in a 4-star Chicago hotel. If our pie wasn't one of the dozens eaten by the hotel customers, it might be thrown away. But the Greater Chicago Food Depository, in an effort to shorten its distribution chain to get nutritious, prepared foods to the needy, might send a driver certified in food handling techniques to pick up that pie. But most food distribution chains are longer. To get that apple from the orchard to a hungry Chicagoan, the Food Depository needed temporary storage. That meant designing and building a massive warehouse and then moving into it from their previous location.
268,000 square feet is the actual operating space. You just can't say, okay, enough is enough. Let's move out of this facility and move into the big brand new facility that's down the street just waiting for us to occupy. It didn't happen that way.
Now, to get our apple directly to the needy, the Greater Chicago Food Depository developed its Produce People Share program. The apple would go from a grower to the warehouse, there to be distributed within days. Produce People Share puts 6 million pounds of highly nourishing fresh fruits and vegetables into impoverished communities every year. So our apple's in good company. But moving that much produce requires a streamlined distribution chain.
We are not going to be left with food in the warehouse that perhaps maybe, because we weren't efficient in our practices, it's going to spoil and we're going to have to dispose of it. There'll be a greater efficiency in the throughput of the products from receiving through shipping.
Our apple may have suffered from some cosmetic defect that rendered it unfit for retail sale, but Bob and his team recognized an opportunity to seize quality, nutritious produce, and they use just-in-time techniques where demands and supply opportunities sometimes meet in a matter of hours.
I'll give you an example. About 2 or 3 days ago, at 6 o'clock in the morning, one of our bigger donors donated pears. Well, we got those pears on the truck. After we examined, looked at it, the pears were in great shape. We quickly moved them from the receiving dock to the shipping dock, but the important thing was to capitalize on the opportunity.
Now, in a supply chain or value chain distribution system, the Chicago Food Depository might have gone right to the farm to pick up our apple, say, through a contract for a specific quantity. But the Chicago Food Depository gets involved later than that after someone has bought the apple and either rejected it or failed to use it for some reason?
Typically, we're talking 5 days, we're talking 4 days, and sometimes we're talking the truck's on the road and we've got to make a stop or else it's lost. I will tell you one incident where we had a trailer load of potatoes. The potatoes were not going to be accepted by their customer, and they wanted to know if we would take the potatoes, because if we didn't take them, the donor would be looking for a place to destroy the product. So it goes from perhaps maybe 5 days to down to hours that we're going to be notified that we have it. That's the dynamics of our business, which is a lot different from the for-profit industry.
Given the variety of its programs, the Food Depository employs various strategies to secure food. It may contract donors for fixed quantities or engineer ways to secure rejected or aging food for redistribution before it's destroyed. The Food Depository employs what in the for-profit world would be an intensive distribution strategy to reach as many of Chicago's needy as possible.
The Greater Chicago Food Depository serves over 91,000 people every single week, and in the course of a year, it's over 300,000 individuals.
Our mission is providing food for hungry people while striving to end hunger in the community. Every day, we're working to provide food through our warehouse, and that's certainly a core mission of ours. The other half of our mission is to break that cycle of poverty for so many individuals that rely on food pantries, soup kitchens, and shelters.
So how much food moves through the distribution chain of the Greater Chicago Food Depository? Well, as we said, they distribute more than 40 million pounds of food annually. That weighs as much as 2 75-car freight trains full of food, including the cars and locomotives. Or, to think of another way, they could serve the entire population of Boca Raton, Florida, a hot meal every day of the year.
The Greater Chicago Food Depository really makes a difference in the lives of tens of thousands of Chicagoans here. The food that we distribute in the course of the year is basically worth about $90 million, okay? And we do that on about a $10 million a year operational budget.
The Food Depository is like a wholesaler that moves bulk products to distribution centers and a retailer that puts products directly into consumers' hands. They further blur the lines found in for-profit distribution chains in that they serve as their own market intermediaries, adding value to the very processes that they create. This added value not only secures more volunteer work hours, it also liberates some of the people that the Food Depository serves by giving them a chance at earning a good living. The meals that they cook go to programs like Kids Cafe, a partnership with existing after-school children's programs where the Food Depository provides nutritious meals to some of the neediest children in Chicago.
It's an after-school feeding program for children. We got 29 of them. And this is a safe haven where kids can go after school to get a full-up meal.
It's been a blessing because we, you know, within this community, we see a lot of hunger and a lot of poverty. And not only are we able to serve the kids, but we're able to serve, you know, their parents when they come and pick them up.
And these kids, and we test them, they're more successful in school. They'll break the cycle of poverty for themselves.
The Greater Chicago Food Depository is always innovating new ways to get food to Chicago's hungriest citizens. They try to shorten the distribution chain in as many ways as possible. One of the quickest ways they have to get our apple to the needy is to put it on the Produce Mobile, a truck that moves produce directly into poor neighborhoods and hands the produce out for free.
The Produce Mobile is a mobile farmer's market, as we like to call it. It essentially is a mechanism for us to directly distribute food to the needy. Our primary business is to distribute food to our agencies, who in turn distribute the food to the needy. They have to provide some volunteer support to command the stations at the Produce Mobile. But this is a direct distribution mechanism. When we detailed the vehicle, it was I always thought that was a very important component, because if you were sitting in your house, wherever that may be, or in your apartment, and you notice that there's a trailer out there, all you would see is a white roof. What I want them to see is the fact that there's food out there. The Greater Chicago Food Depository is out there. Go on down there and get some food.
We're out here every day making a difference in the lives of individuals, but from a business perspective, it's the smart thing to do. It's really an economic imperative, because if we can feed children, then we've got children that are going to graduate from school, and they're going to get a job, and they're going to go to college, okay? They're going to end up being taxpayers, contributing to our society, and improving our economy. That's what we really want to do at the end of the day.